being in public, like this, I'm sorry, just moving your body in this direction. One time you're really in trouble, and a confrontation is when you're out of public. This is the maximum distance between his attack and my body. This move here. That line is cut. So I got this hand, and I've got this foot. So when I practice, but practice is not real. Practice is something that we do to teach our body to move in a certain way. But real, if you're using it for self-defense, it's not going to be pretty. It's not going to be technique. But your body has to react within the shape of the technique that you learn. Understand? So here is something that I'm sure. I can't put this man this down in this tone. My feet have to move just before my hands. I can't push it down in this hand. Just put this here. Then when he pushes back, he has to push my whole body, not just my arm. Relate to that idea? What? This is wrong. This is right. It's not that. But this is that. This foot moves the hand in this hand. Now I'm in my cat position. This is the circle. And now you use a circle. So you have to train your body to not do this, right? Start forcing your muscle against this muscle. Here, this is muscle. Then I reach. You're reaching. If you do this, you don't know. But this is the running. Understand the relationship between the pony, Steven Seagal, walks this way.
Right?
Slightly exaggerated, but it's a fact. You have to move this way. So you can practice that idea. So, don't try to do this. Feel your muscle? All right, feel your muscle. Feel your muscle. Where's your muscle? This is what I want you to feel. Okay. Now, this is kind of tricky. Maybe I have all my piece of the elephant. might be slightly different from another teacher is where he's grabbed the elephant, fly with the elephant. Okay. So that's what I work on. My piece of the elephant is what I'm trying to give you. If it works along with anything else you learn, then I'm filling in a piece of the elephant. Because it's a big animal, you're going to get a lot of pieces. And some of them are going to be upside down for a long time. So get them come together into what I call Aikido. It's really a pattern of study moving in a way that's precise. Concentrating on precision, one comes to technique. And concentrating on technique, one never comes to precision. It's written about music, but it applies so well to music. You have to concentrate on the hard part, not the easy part. Practice this should always be hard. You should never be able to do it perfectly. You should be able to do this. I can feel what he's doing. And every time we grasp me, it's going to be a different feeling. What do I have to do? Feel his intention. So this is the hard part of practice. And here, that's not going to work. Maybe it doesn't work. I try focus. Attention maybe works, but maybe I start here. This doesn't work, but this will work. But instead, that's another hand for me, right? With the strength. Hold the tension, it works. I think we got plan A, plan B, plan C, plan O. Oh. So you're always following Uke's desire, not your own. You have to find out what he wants. Oh, he doesn't want, this. Oh, he wants this thing.
Thank you.
see, or I could see a better one. Well, once I was demonstrating a karate motion, I forgot to take my glasses off. And so I went through the demonstration. And afterwards, afterwards, I was in the dressing room, and I heard two of the karate black folks say, I didn't think much of the old man's Aikido. I'm not impressed with what he met his glasses on. So I leave my glasses on. Pretty bad at karate. So this rule here, this is moving to your center here. This is expanding in the whole field. Now if he doesn't want to go down this way, he moves into the other field. Always come back to Tokyo or Ikkyo. The sensei was asked, how many techniques are there in Aikido? He said one. Which is a view. Always entering. You can never back up. You can move backwards as long as you're going out in front. Okay? You can never back up. I won't go. You can get into trouble. I keep entering. They also said, if you're doing it, you're doing it. So two things you can play with. Every technique goes to the Aikido or Aikido. And then everything else starts from there again. Understand the idea? So you're always coming back to the basic, and the basic then tells you where to go from there. Actually, in this case, the basic tells you where to go. So play with inside. Here, this little exercise is teaching your body to move into pain. So nothing's happening here. Time for you to shoot over. Move, open, move, move. Around and cut, I can see you, and you measure it. I can't bend from here. I have to scoop. As I said, this is moving here. Have you heard these before? You're not going to do this. That's right. So that means his mind is clear. Okay? No, he's not going to let me do this. Let's cut back into it. From the shape. So I think it's important that you don't try to do this. It's important to try to do this. And a lot of, if I do this too soon, if I turn my head over, which way is my knee going?
Right.
Okay. But if I do this, which way is my knee going?
Oh!
The other question, which way is my knee going? Which way is the strength going? Which way is the strength going? Nothing's happening to me. The idea? Keep your hands flat as long as you can this way, and then they have to turn your eyes. Don't do this first. That's theory of Aikido. You need space, which is my, you need time. You need some time, you need space. You have to come out in this position. Can't do this. I'm rushing, I'm doing the technique before my body is ready for it. Can't do this. This one, I want to be out here. Luke wants this hand, that's what he's hanging on with. I want him to have it, he's still got it. That makes room for this hand. I'm going to rush this hand and forget about this one. Okay, now I'm in trouble. Okay. Everything he does is going to. Right. So, I want you to take the time from the full, this is where you want to be. Worth the time to take the time to make the technique precisely perfect. Because until you do it perfectly, you're going to keep doing it different every time. And your body's not going to learn it. It's going to learn a dozen different ways to know what to do it for. Without thinking. This you have to practice. This idea. And until that becomes so natural that you can't do it any other way. So take the time to not do the technique. This is doing the technique. Take the time to move your own center. Here's your sword.
How strong Ute is.
They got a problem with this. So for practice, I'll find these things. This is practice. Nothing is happening here. Nothing can't say I'm pushing you out. No. It's just around. This tight spiral. Does that make sense?
Thank you.
goes.
Thank you.
talk, I really can't feel good about what I'm trying to show you. It's strictly non-Japanese. The talk of Japanese classic, it's like a lumberjack. Anyhow, but following along with that, always coming in, always in, you have to make room. You're always changing from one comedy to the other, and you have to make room for the other side to get in. And I can't come in with this side until I've got rid of this side. And this is what 10 pounds is for. And that communication strength goes through. Now from here, where do you want to go from there, okay? Well, this is the very basic tendon. That's making room for your body. The arms are going to come all the way around here. So do a bit. If he wants this arm, where you go, okay? That's it. So you have to move out of the way to make room for the other side of your body. And you're always changing from one side of your body to the other. Was made about space and time. Lots of space. Lots of space. Lots of time. Now where are we going? Thank you. thing. My guys, come up to this. And the upper legs are pretty broad. And it's always horizontal. Go back to the tight. You can do it then you can. Then biting the other hand. Then biting the other hand.
I'm thinking about a technique that I can't come up with.
Now, when you're practicing any striking technique, forget the technique, only defend yourself. So concentrate on the block. Strike. This is, if you get that part right, the rest will come out all by itself. So I'm thinking about, I'm going to do a technique. You blow it every time, so strike. That's good enough. So if you're bigger and stronger, the technique will come out of that defense. Strike. This is right. joy. Anything change?
You have 5 minutes.
You have another 5 minutes? Okay. I have a couple more secrets. Now, think of, stretch your arms higher than, let your hands drop down this way. So just the weight of your head is forcing your arms up. You feel just the weight of your head is forcing your arms up. Here's a smoke. And what you're doing is making your little finger the strongest part of your body. This is the point. Oh, this is the tip of your sword. There's a lot of advantages. Ah, this is the sword. I'll show you what is wrong. This is wrong. What is the difference between this and this? Okay? You tell me. If you're feeling it, what's wrong with this? All your shoulders and muscles against my shoulders and muscles. No, it's this. Because there's nothing in there. So how can you play against it? No. Come here.
Why, Matthew?
What's that?
down, right on here, we make sort of a half circle to the
other. Half circle, yeah.
Right. Yeah, same? Yeah. We can all bow to each other at the same time.
I feel like I'm on a pilgrimage. Terry was a close friend, good close acquaintance. I respected his thoughts and his Aikido. And I hope that anything I've been able to leave with you will follow in his process. I'm sure it does because he has a disciple, I think, who can do it, and will follow the thought process of Aikido. Aikido is only an idea. It's not what you see on the map. It's an idea that Bill Sensei had about reconciling, reconciliation, loving the attacker. Without that idea, there's no Aikido. There's only jujitsu, hundreds of years old, designed to kill people. Sensei's techniques were not meant to do that. They were meant to save the attacker, create a friend. So start working on the philosophy, because without it, you won't be doing Aikido. Understand? I thank you again for the use of your bodies and minds and the privilege of being here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.